Despite you can reduce the amount of light with the variable aperture on the Mavic 2 Pro, there's really no way around ND filters if you want to capture cinematic footage. I got this new set of filters from Freewell that includes both normal and polarized versions that I'll be using in this video. When you have watched this video, you will be an expert in selecting the right filter for your drone, and you will also understand why you need them. But before we get to that, let's roll that intro. Welcome and nice to see you. And if you want to improve your drone footage skills, then consider subscribing to my weekly tips, tests and tutorials. When I made a similar video for the Mavic Air about using ND filters, I started the video by explaining all the background from why you need the filters. This time I will do it different and start out by showing you how to select the right filter so you can get going if you already know the basics. If you're in doubt why you need them, then you should watch the remaining part of the video and it will all make sense. So how do you mount these filters? For this example, we're using the 4K series all day filter pack from Freewell. This package contains an ND4, ND8 and ND16, a circular polarized filter, an ND8 polarized, ND16 polarized, ND32 polarized and finally an ND64 polarized. There's a lot of options included in this pack and that should be more than sufficient for most needs. The way that you mount a filter is that you turn the front plate on the camera and thereby detaching the original glass filter and remove that. The filter can only be mounted in one direction as one of the mounting holes have been made different. Then you take a Freewell filter and you put it in the same position and you twist it the opposite direction and then it's mounted in place. I'm not really sure I like the way the filters are mounting on the 1-inch camera. I like the solution with the thread a lot better from the Mavic Air. But this has nothing to do with the Freewell kit, as this is the way DJI designed it. With the polarized version, you can turn the front ring to either increase or decrease the polarizing effect. This filter seems like a pretty decent quality, made from aluminum and multi-coated glass, and they're very light, so I don't expect them to add additional strain on the gimbal. While we are talking Freewell, they also make filter solutions for all the other DJI drones. There's a link in the description below. The reason for using ND filters is to generate motion blur, so the camera settings needs to be prepared for that. This method applies to all filters, regardless manufacturer. Let's flick the camera into manual, as this will give us full control. ISO is fixed on 100 for the best quality, but also for the darkest image. The shutter needs to be set at the double of the frame rate, so in this case 1/50. Remember to change your shutter speed if you decide to use a different frame rate. Because we can adjust the amount of light that hits the sensor with the variable aperture on the Mavic 2 Pro, we should select a value that's somewhere in the middle, like 5.6 or 6.3, as this will give us headroom to adjust. This is a luxury we didn't have with the fixed aperture drones like the Mavic Pro and the Mavic Air. Even the Mavic 2 Zoom does not have this option to adjust in flight. For this example, we will be using 4K 25 frames per second. As this is a 1-inch Hasselblad camera, it would be kind of cheesy to use only 1080p. With the color profile, you need to decide if you want to work with the footage directly out of the camera. In that case, H264 and color profile none will do the job perfectly fine. If you want to work with the footage in post and color grade and color correct the footage, you should go for H265 and the D-Log M color profile. That profile will give you the most dynamic range to work with in post-production. We keep the style setting to 000 for now, but you could decide to turn down the contrast and saturation for an even flatter color profile. White balance should be set to match the weather. So if it's sunny, it needs to be sunny, but today is unfortunately a bit cloudy, so we need to select cloudy. I could probably make a whole separate video about that topic. An easy way for you to make sure your exposure is set correctly is to enable the histogram from the camera settings along with the overexposure warnings shown as tiger stripes in the interface. These tools will help you to see if your picture has been exposed correctly. Especially the histogram is very useful as a graphical representation of the pixels exposed in your view. The left side of the graph represents the blacks and the shadows, the right side represents the highlights or bright areas, and the middle section covering the midtones. This is an easy way to determine if your picture is under or overexposed, as the charts will be pushed either to the left or the right side. An ideal histogram should be evenly distributed edge to edge and not squeezed to either side. There are of course exceptions, but this is the general approach. Mount the filler that matches the guideline from the package and fire up the system. And start pointing your drone in the direction that you plan to fly and check your histogram. If the scene is too dark, you should switch to a lighter filter with a lower ND value. If the scene is too bright, you need to mount a darker ND filter with a higher number. If it's only a little bit off, you can do fine adjustments with the aperture setting. Try to get the EV value or the exposure compensation value as close as you can to zero, preferably within 0.7 plus minus. And this is where it gets really brilliant, because you can do these fine adjustments in flight if the light is changing, and that's pretty smart. A pro tip is always to expose for the brightest area, as it's much easier to recover the dark areas than the blown out highlights. So now you know how to pick the right filter for your Mavic 2 Pro. But if you have additional questions, then leave them in the comment section below. Let's jump into the background behind the filters so you know why and when you need them. I covered this topic in a previous video, so let's replay that part because the principles are the same. What is a neutral density or ND filter? The sole purpose of an ND filter is to reduce the amount of light coming through your lens. A pure ND filter does not change your footage or improve your colors. ND filters are typically labeled with numbers like 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64. There's a longer explanation between the correlation between f-stops and ND numbers, but you don't need to know that to use ND filters. You just need to know that a higher number means a darker filter. For drones, there are typically two types of filters, a standard ND filter and a polarized version. Before we talk about the difference, let's understand why we need them. Why we need an ND filter for drone video. ND filters are used to generate motion blur in your footage, making motions more pleasant to the eye. We are used to seeing motion blur from the movies, so this is by the human eye perceived natural. You can try and wave the hand in front of you. This is a handy example of motion blur. You got that? Let's look at an example. If we stop the frame, you can see the top frame has clearly defined motion blur, where the bottom frame stays crisp and sharp. Adding motion blur to your footage makes a huge difference, making the footage look buttery smooth and not harsh, jerky and unnatural. To obtain motion blur, we need to obey the 180 degree rule, where we reduce the shutter speed to the double of the frame rate. If the term shutter speed is new to you, this is the length of time when the digital sensor inside the camera is exposed to light. As an example, if you shoot at 30 frames per second, your shutter speed should be 1/60 or 60 depending on your UI. When do you need an ND filter? When you're outside in the bright sun and you need to slow that shutter down to generate motion blur, you need to reduce the amount of light that hits the sensor for your picture not to be overexposed. With the Mavic 2 Pro, we can do this with the variable aperture and increase the f-stop to reduce the amount of light. Aperture is the iris inside the lens that opens and closes depending on how much light you want to let in. The maximum setting is f11, but this is far from enough to cover us at bright daylight. With ISO set to the lowest level at 100 and the aperture maxed out at f11, the only way to reduce the amount of light is to add an ND filter, like a pair of sunglasses. Do I need to use filters every time I'm outside? The short answer is no. ND filters are primarily only needed if there are motion in the picture. If you're far away from moving objects or high above the ground filming a landscape at slow speed without panning too much, you won't see much of a difference regardless of the shutter speed. But in general, you will benefit from lowering that shutter speed, as this will help you get rid of some of the jerkiness and stuttering that you sometimes see in drone footage recorded with very high shutter speeds. Especially seen if you are filming moving objects, panning the camera or flying close to the ground. When do you need a polarized ND filter? Polarized filters are used in general to darken skies and manage reflections or remove glare from surfaces of the sea or lakes. A polarized filter can enhance the colors of vegetation because of reduced reflections, otherwise making the footage looks desaturated and flat. If you do drone landscape footage, glare and reflections are not the most common problem. As an example, if you take away the reflection from a lake, it might look dead and unnatural. Getting a nice blue sky with clouds sticking out, this is where polarized filters really can help. You can simplify this by saying that you basically only need a polarized filter if you want to add an artistic effect to your footage. You mostly benefit from using polarizers on sunny days, but you can also use them on cloudy days to make the sky look more dramatic. You need to be aware that the polarizing effect changes with the horizontal leveling of your aircraft. But with a gimbal stabilized camera, this shouldn't be much of an issue. A polarizer filter can be combined with an ND filter. This is why you see offerings saying ND polarized filters from companies like Freewell or like. The filter effect can be maximized or minimized when you turn the outer ring of the filter. This could be the argument for selecting the polarized version in case you don't want to buy both. If you have any additional questions, then feel free to pop them in the comment section below. In this video, I have, as mentioned, used the Freewell All Day kit, and this is a pretty good kit that offers a lot of value for the money. Let's look at some footage shot with the filters from Freewell. And in case you want to pick up a kit, you can find a link in the description below. The polarizing effect does not seem as strong as I would expect, but it will give you a full filter range from ND4 to ND64. How good is Active Track 2.0 with the new Mavic 2 series? I set my mind to find out, so I did a quite extensive test of this, and you can watch how that went and if I managed to crash the drone by this card. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, then make sure to give it a like. That makes it a lot easier for everyone else to find the same video and benefit from the content. Thank you for watching, and see you on the next one.